In the last lecture, we saw the theory part of TApply, and today we are going to see how do you use TApply function in R. Welcome to the practicals of TApply. The same dataset, the iris dataset, we are going to use, but now we are going to see how the TApply function works. It is a bit different from apply, I'll apply and sApply. So here, if you have a columnar data which has categories into it, you can subset the entire data frame by those and you perform a function on them. So let us say if I have an iris data set and I want to calculate the mean of say sepal length of among the different species. Can I do that? Yes, you can. And you do it by saying tApply iris comma 1 comma. The second thing that you apply is the name of a column which contains the categorical data. So I'll say iris dollar species, and the last is the function that you want to apply. I'll say mean and I'll run it. So you can see Setosa, versicolor and virginica. So what it, when I said to divide the data amongst the species and calculate the mean for iris first column, that is sepal length, what it did, it divided firstly the Setosa, calculated the mean for the sepal length, then it divided the data for versicolor, calculated the mean, and same for virginica. So this is how the tApply function works. You can also use the user defined function instead of predefined functions. But if I want to say, let's say if I want to display for all the columns, can I do that? Yes, you can. But before going for that demonstration, let me display if tApply works for entire data set. So I'll say iris 1 to 4 iris dollar species comma mean. It is giving me error. Instead of the iris first four column is numerical, it is giving me error. Why? Because it is a requirement for tApply to give a vector in it. So hence it will consider only the one vector at a time. But if I want to display for all the columns, then so we'll use the for loop which we had used in the previous chapter. So I'll say for I in call names of iris 1 to 4. Fine, I'll copy the same function here, but instead of 1 I'll say I. Fine, I'll give control enter, misspelled the iris name here. I'll say control enter. It ran everything, but it didn't display anything because I did not use the function print. I'll say print and I'll run. So it is giving me for all the columns. So it is a confusion for which column for the output is given here. So I'll say print I. Fine, I'll run it again. So for sepal length, these are the outputs. For petal length, these are the outputs. For sepal width, and correspondingly for all the columns. So this is how you deal with the different functions of apply family. So this was the practical demonstration of the tApply function that we had discussed theoretically.
So this brings an end of the fifth chapter, the loop functions, where we saw apply, sApply, lApply and tApply theoretically and practically both. And in the next lecture, we are going to see the sixth chapter of our course, Handling Dates in R.